Good evening.
Good evening.
I want to welcome you to our Vespers program this evening. Before we get started, I want to remind you of a couple of events still to come. It's been a full day already, but we still have the basketball game after this tonight, 9:15 in the gym. So we want to invite you to that, as well as the disc golf tournament tomorrow morning, 10 to 2. Again, reminder, you don't have to have a reservation. You don't have to have a tee time. For any golfers here, just come on out and have a good time. Tomorrow morning, again, looks like a beautiful day. But we're here to enjoy some music. There are so many bragging points here at Shenandoah. That is the first time. I was thinking SVA. Do I want to say SVA? Do I want to say the wrong school? Here's Spring Valley Academy. There we go. For those of you that don't know, I did spend 4 years at the other SVA. But anyway, there's so many bragging points here at Spring Valley. One of those is definitely the music program. Hands down, the best I've ever been a part of. And that's pretty awesome. And so we look forward to hearing from Valley Brass and Aeolus Woodwind Quintet here this evening. And so we're glad that you've come to join us. And I would invite you to bow your heads with me in prayer as we begin. Father God, we again pause from our activities, pause from what we're doing to say we do all of this because we recognize that you are our God. You have given us life. You've given us the ability to live life, to have friends and relationships. You've given us this school that we can be a part of, and we just want you to be a part of our program here tonight. So we invite your spirit to come and join us as we enjoy the music and we worship you here tonight. And so come and join us. Bless us, we pray in your name. Amen. Let's give it up for Valley Brass. Thank you.
Thank you. Cornelius Wind Quintet, and this group has kind of been a dream of mine for a while now, and it started all about a year ago when Mr. Huff had a stage band concert, and I said, Mr. Huff, I want to do something in a smaller group, but there's no woodwinds. And so that's where our woodwind quintet came from, and it started as Justice for Woodwinds, and then we changed that name, but it's still our favorite. How many of you have heard your favorite hymn tonight? A couple of you. Okay, a couple of you. This next song is one of my family's favorite hymns. And we always are listening to it, different versions of it. And my dad came across this really cool song version of Nearer My God to Thee. But it was written for brass quintet, as all the fun songs are. But Mr. Vargas came in and transposed it for us. And so we get to play it for you tonight. So this is the world premiere of Woodwind Quintet, Nearer My God to Thee. So big thanks to Mr. Vargas and to Mrs. Kabomsog, who is our piano accompanist. Yeah. Something.
Thank you. cool was that? Yeah. So proud of this group for their initiative to make this group happen, and they rehearse on, you know, they schedule their rehearsals, they pick their music. Sometimes they reply to my emails when I need information from them, but so proud of them. And look, they're adding repertoire to the woodwind quintet world, so wonderful job. The next piece, Sonata Piano Forte, was written by Giovanni Gabrielli. Gabrielli was a Renaissance composer that for about 25 years, he was the minister of music at St. Mark's in Venice. And during that time, he is accredited with being one of the first composers to write specifically for brass instruments. And if you were at his church any given weekend, you'd probably hear some different sonatas or canzonas or different things like that. It would often feature two choirs of instruments in, they had choir lofts there, they still do, facing each other. And you'd have one choir here, one choir there, maybe even eight trombones, four over here, four over there, and they would play antiphonal music. Well, tonight we're going to play one of those songs, probably his most famous composition, Sonata Piano Forte, kind of recognizes dynamics, piano, forte, it's kind of the juxtaposition. And it'll feature the Woodwind Quintet here, Choir 1, and the Valley Brass back there, Choir 2, Sonata Piano Forte.
Thank you.
as I said, we've got great, fabulous music here, and we're proud of that. One of these proud points of Spring Valley Academy. Mr. Huff, I have to confess that while you were up here directing and the woodwinds were not playing, it reminded me of many times in class where I'm talking and they don't seem to be paying attention, but at least the brass were paying attention there. I can't even imagine how difficult a piece that was to play, but it was fantastic, so thank you for that. If you were here earlier, you heard me say I got to go with the music department to Ireland over spring break for their trip, and it was a fantastic trip. Enjoyed it greatly, enjoyed spending time with the students, getting to know some of you as parents, seeing the beauty of Ireland, learning much about the history of Ireland and even current things that are going on there. And we're about to see a slideshow that Holly Maycumber has put together on that. Holly was also on the trip. And so she's put together a slideshow that we're going to experience here in just a moment. But I wanted to let you know that immediately following the slideshow, we're going to collect up an offering. And the proceeds of that offering will continue to offset the expense of that trip. I remember when we landed in Dublin after a red eye, leaving here on Sunday, getting in Dublin Monday morning, and one of the things we had to do is locate where are the tubas and the trombones, the big instruments, because they didn't come out on the regular baggage plane, and realize, man, that takes money to do. And we didn't take timpani and all the drums and all the percussion. We did take cymbals and almost didn't get those back, but that's another story. But we had to rent instruments there, and we had to have a truck to take them from place to place. And so there was a lot of expenses that went into making that trip happen. And so our offering tonight will help to continue to cover those expenses. But I look forward to this slideshow, to reliving those memories. You'll get a chance to see Ireland, to some of the experience that we had there last month. And thank you so much, Holly, for your hard work in putting this together. So let's enjoy our slideshow for Ireland. Thank you.
they're going to collect that offering now. When we do, I'm going to reminisce for a second. As being part of Alumni Weekend, if you were here last year at this concert, we kind of went through all the different groups and different Valley Brass members gave memories. So I began teaching here in 1995, and this is my 24th year here, so the math's a little weird if you add it up. I was gone for 5 years in there. But in 95, by Christmas time, we started what we call Valley Brass, and that ran for 11 years, and then a few years after I had left. And then when I came back, this is my 13th year back. Well, the first 10 years, we didn't actually have a Valley Brass group. I was teaching part-time, and so this is the third year Valley Brass has been going. So when you play in a brass quintet, the name Canadian Brass is kind of like the pillar. They started in 1970. And not only for brass, but for chamber music in general, they are major. They started chamber music being really popular, where you would go to a Canadian brass concert and pay a lot of money to see them, which is really exciting. Well, in the process, they have published a ton of music, so you can get hundreds of Canadian brass publications. So much of what we play is Canadian brass arrangements for brass quintet. This year particularly has been a really big year for Valley Brass and Canadian Brass. At Christmas time, Canadian Brass was in town and we got to go to their concert at the Schuster Center with the Danian Philharmonic. And one thing really special about that concert was their new trumpet player was a female for the first time, and she was from Dayton. This was her home. So I actually remember one time coming into one of the classrooms and she was here giving a workshop to one of the elementary classes here. So that kind of started things, and after the concert we got to meet them, get pictures with them, and so on. Well, shortly after that, we find out that they're going to be doing a concert at Andrews. And the band director Andrews contacted us and said, hey, would you like to come up and do a workshop with them? And we're like, yeah. And so we made it work, cat allergies and all. We made it up to Andrews and we got to play for and with the Canadian Brass. So in my 30 plus years of doing brass quintet stuff, that's a first for me. So it was a really big deal, still is a very big deal. So that happened, and then we got to go to their concert. So again, it's been a really big Canadian Brass year. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute, but it's amazing how similar Valley Brass is to Canadian Brass. So let me tell you, this is kind of how I'm setting up the story. So we both have a Greek trombone player. Yeah. So, yeah. Their original trombone player, Eugene Watts, was actually from Missouri, so I had that connection when I was growing up. And the guy that replaced him, I think they've only had two trombone players since 1970, is Antilles, who's from Greek. And the two of them got together and they started talking Greek. It was crazy. So that's the first connection. Second one is, like I said, they just got their first female trumpet player in there. What? That's 54 years. Yeah. Well, we have a female trumpet player. It's not our first one, but we do have a female trumpet player. And then, I forgot to tell my group this when I was telling this the other day. In their group, Chuck Dallenbach is the original tuba player from 1970. He'll be 79 in July. And he's still traveling around with these 20, 30 years old, you know. They've gone through tons of trumpet and horn players. I mean, many, many, many. But this is the original tuba player. So the old guy in the group is the tuba player. The old guy in the group is the tuba player. He has me by 20 plus years now, so I have a long ways to keep up with Chuck. But they don't and never have had a Jamaican trumpet player. So we have them beat, in my opinion. So the song that we got to play with and for them at the workshop, we're going to play next. Here is Canadian Brass's arrangement of Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
So after the Christmas concert we went to, I asked the group, I said, what do you guys really want to play that they did? And they picked the Saints' Hallelujah. So that's very applicable for a couple reasons, I figure. Number one, a couple of these guys really, really love jazz. All right, so much so, like, Sophia and her mom even made a trip to New Orleans just because to, you know, find the birthplace of jazz. Also this year, we got to do the Hallelujah Chorus as part of our Irish Christmas concert, and these four were the soloists for the Hallelujah Chorus. And when we were in Dublin, we got to go see the exact location where George Frideric Handel premiered the Messiah and the Hallelujah Chorus. So this is the Saints' Hallelujah. But I didn't realize how hard the tuba part was. So there's over 500 notes I'm supposed to play on this song. So I promise I won't get quite all 500 in. I'll try to keep up. But this group is so good that they tell me what they want to play, and before I even give them the music, they come back and have half of it learned and memorized. I'm not kidding. Somehow they listen to the recording, and boom. They really are an amazing group, and I've been trying to keep up with them this year. So, unfortunately, like the world of academia, once you get to a point, you know, they just leave. That's kind of how it works, so we'll be starting over next year. But I really appreciate these guys. I've been part-time. I'm a little jaded when I have to come in for rehearsal on Mondays and Wednesdays and my day off, but because of them, it's always worth it. So I appreciate you guys, and again, thanks for coming tonight. We're going to end with the Saints' Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Fantastic. How about that Greek trombone player? And that Jamaican trumpet player. I got to tell you, Zaid, I saw Mom down there videoing and said, that ain't my little boy. Way to go, man. Good job. Good job. Fantastic. We've enjoyed the concert. I also wanted to say to Emily, thank you for having a vision of a woodwind group and seeing that through and making that happen and blessing us here tonight. That was excellent. Thank you so much for that. Again, thank you to Holly for the trip. It brought back lots of memories of that trip and the fantastic time. If you couldn't tell, we had a good time there. It did rain once or twice. I tell people if I had one word to describe Ireland, it would be wet. Give me two words, it would be very wet. Three words would be wet, green, and beautiful. And so it was a great time. But thank you for coming out tonight. Thank you for coming to Alumni Weekend. We still have our basketball game here at 9:15. Invite you to stand with me as we close our evening here with prayer. Father God, thank you so, so much for the talents of these young people and just blessing us here tonight. We've enjoyed the music. We've heard praises to you, and we've seen the abilities that you've given, and may they continue to use them to serve you. Thank you for this alumni weekend, this great day that we've had together here. Continue to be with us. Continue to be with as we finish out the school year. May we have a great end over these last few weeks, and continue to bless Spring Valley Academy, your school. We pray in your name. Amen. Amen. Oh, Don, I meant to tell you, I got up to 483. I lost count there, so I'm not sure where we are. Good job.